Hello and welcome to Market Talks, a series of podcasts presented by Argus addressing the main events impacting commodities and the energy sector in Brazil and around the world. My name is Camila Dias, I'm Argus Brazil Country Manager, and in today's episode I talk to Kauanna Navarro, the Latin American reporter for the Argus Americas Base Oils publication, about the supply and demand on the base oils market both globally and in Latin America. Welcome, Kauanna.
Hi, Camila. It is a pleasure to talk to you.
Kauanna, how is the demand for base oils in Latin American markets after 2 years of the pandemic and with the ongoing conflict in Europe?
Camila, the Latin American markets have indeed suffered from the economic recession caused by the pandemic. People were locked in their homes for almost a year, waiting for the vaccines. This reduced car usage and consequently reduced finished lubricant changes. The industry also demands base oils, but operation capacity has been reduced worldwide, bringing lubricant demand down with it. The scenario is worse when we consider economies not so consolidated as Europe countries or the US, like we have here in Latin America. Here, demand was slow in 2020 and continued so in 2021. And when all the engines seemed to be back to their regular rhythm, the Russia-Ukraine conflict messed up supply and slowed demand recovery. In the last few months, though, we have seen Latin American base oils demand increase as supplies tighten in regional and global markets, not because finished lubricant sales are back to prior pandemic levels, but more as a result of fewer inventories.
It's not an easy scenario for base oils, Kauanna, as you were saying. You mentioned the Russia-Ukraine conflict impacted the supply. Could you explain more for us?
Russian supplies are no longer moving to the European market. This has left a supply gap to be covered by regional Group 1 and Group 2 suppliers. Russia typically produces around 1.2 million metric tons per year of Group 1 base oils. Most to supply the Russian domestic market and its surrounding regional markets. And may also move to the European market. But Russian supplies have stopped moving to Europe after EU sanctions and boycotts stopped shipments.
Kauanna, is this the main reason for tight global supply?
Not really. Besides the escalating conflict between Russia and Ukraine, European market had a heavy round of regional plant maintenance. At least 24% of European Group 1 nameplate capacity was offline in June, according to Argus Proprietary Supply Index, as three key refineries in the region had overlapping maintenances. Now, these maintenances are almost finished and production is returning to normal levels.
Kauanna, Latin markets mostly import products from the US, right? How does Europe affect our markets?
There are two different situations on this topic. First, US supply was also reduced. Group 2 availability is tight, following a sooner than expected maintenance at several key US Gulf Coast refineries. In June, a key refinery replaced its catalyst. Another two refineries will switch out catalysts in the third quarter of this year and in the first quarter of 2023. Firm domestic demand is also keeping US supply balanced. Some market participants are building and maintaining inventories during the Atlantic hurricane season, which runs from June until the end of November. There is limited spot availability for Latin America because of that. The second issue is that Latin markets do purchase Group 2 base oils produced in Europe, not only in the US. Meanwhile, Group 1 tightness has left supply gap to be covered by regional Group 1 and Group 2 supplies. Group 1 blenders are switching their formulations to Group 2, which has raised Group 2 costs. Higher base oil price can also be attributed to costlier feedstocks and tighter vacuum gas oil supplies, both affected by sanctions on Russian oil and refined products. In June, the VGO premium to WTI crude oil rose to the highest level since March 2013.
Kauanna, basically, are Latin American markets disputing for product with Europe and the United States? And how is the situation with the Asia-Pacific region?
The demand in Europe is weakening, and current prices and freight rates are discouraging Latin American buyers. In Asia Pacific, weaker regional demand and increasing output have boosted spot availability. Some of these excess supplies are targeting the Latin market, where more South American buyers are willing to accept higher price to attract imports. But logistical constraints, limited vessel space, and rising freight rates have dampened the flow of more Asian Pacific arbitrage shipments to the region.
Kauanna, besides the supply situation, do we also have logistical problems then?
Absolutely. I would have even say that logistics are now as important or maybe even more important than the supply tightness.
Why do you say that?
That's because the maintenances are finished up. Also, Europe demand is not so strong as in the US, but logistics are a huge problem, and the end of the tunnel is not clear yet. Currently, there aren't many vessels to send to South American markets. When there is one, there isn't enough space for cargoes averaging 7,000 tons. Besides, we are facing a global shortage of bunker supply, which has generated demand from some ship owners to lock in volume through forward contracts. And not many fuel sellers can meet such requests. Also, freight rates keep increasing, which makes imports less competitive for Latin buyers.
Kauanna, all those factors apply to Brazil, but is there something else you would add about the Brazilian base oil scenario?
I always have something more to say about Brazil, Camila.
That's for sure.
Our domestic production is typically sufficient to cover demand, but recent price increases have encouraged some Brazilian buyers to seek alternative suppliers. Imports to Brazil are expected to increase in the second half of the year. Brazilian refineries are prioritizing diesel production because of high margins. Domestic demand for motor fuels is expected to increase ahead of and during the final quarter of the year, during the peak agriculture season. This is expected to reduce domestic base oil production, making Brazilian buyers more reliant on imports to cover any additional demand. And usually the domestic prices in Brazil are lower than Europe or even Asia. This scenario is changed in the last few months, and Petrobras prices are becoming more in line with global prices. Brazilian domestic Group 1 and naphthalic base oils price continue to increase. The price rose by 20% in April, 15% in May, and increased another 10% in June. In July, the rhythm of the increase reduced, and the price rose by around 4%.
Yes, Kauanna, there is a lot going on in the Latin American base oils market then. Thank you so much for being with us at Market Talks. These and other episodes of our podcast are available on the Argus website at www.argusmedia.com. Visit the page to follow the events that affect global commodity markets and understand their developments in Brazil and in Latin America. We'll be back soon with another edition of Market Talks. See you soon.